What makes it different in the South? Every farm had a family cemetery on it.
150 years ago, there were no organized cemeteries. Everybody just buried their families on their lands.
When the developer comes in and buys the whole farm, the lots around it, nobody would buy them with a cemetery like this all grown up.
They approached us about developing the land and wanted to move the cemetery. I'm not very fond of moving cemeteries.
I know that they're akin to me. I mean, they're my blood. So, I mean, that's the reason I wanted to be here today. Otherwise, I wouldn't have, you know, been concerned with it.
I'm an embalmer and a funeral director in North Carolina. So I do things different from what the funeral homes do. I dig them up, right? Reverse funeral director. Here's one right here. Here's one right here. When I came out here and looked for the soft spots, and I came up with about 15. We actually start in the northeast corner, and we keep crossing the cemetery until we're through with it. We probably cover an area 60% larger than the actual cemetery. So that's a baby. Or a child. They were buried in wood boxes. The body decomposed, the box rotted, and everything settled down into the bottom of the grave. It's compressed into the bottom 2 to 3 inches of the grave. If we get into them and start removing them, they get very interested. You can relate to your granddaddy, but it would probably be hard for you to relate to your great-grandfather. You didn't know him.
Can you get a picture of that on that side?
These people start to come alive to you because you know a little bit about them. You know something about them. So to see this grave and then to realize that it's a woman, and obviously this necklace was probably her most prized possession for her to still be buried in it. You know, it makes these people take on a personality, even though I'm not quite sure who she is.
And everything that comes out goes back to the beginning.
Which Vic is it?
Shows up good against her.
You don't?
You know, usually people only get together the funeral and weddings, but to get together for this.
Good morning, how you doing?
All right.
Morning.
1, 2, 5.
And you know the first
room. I had no idea how the process worked. And these guys have done such a great job. I am glad this has been done. I worried so much. I didn't sleep for several nights before. But now, instead of having 12 or 13 that we thought was there, we have 28 people that are going to be buried here together, and it's just wonderful.
Oh, this is a piece of cake. It was good sandy soil, good topsoil. Got right down to the clay, and you could see every one of them.
I think they would be glad that their bones are now laid and identified as being a human being. They're here in a cemetery with family, friends, or distant relations, and I think that they will, in a sense, be resting more peacefully.